Hey there, everybody. In this tutorial, we're going to learn the very basics of creating brushes in Adobe Illustrator. Brushes are a really versatile way to add life to any of your vector illustrations. Here, I have two circles overlapping one another, and I'm going to go ahead and go to my Pathfinder. I just want to play with the intersecting areas, and we're going to create this shape that you can see here. I'm going to do Object Expand. Just to be safe, I'm going to rotate this shape to the side. Let's zoom in and adjust this shape. So what we're going to create with this particular shape is the kind of almost calligraphy brush. I'm going to hold S for scale, and I'm going to just kind of pinch those ends in just a bit. How do I turn this into a brush to draw with? If I go to my brush tool, what you'll notice is really by default, we don't have a lot of crazy options here when it comes to brushes. First, you have to make sure that you're on a stroke. When you have the stroke selected, you then can kind of adjust the brushes as you see fit. You could start painting and, you know, creating line work, you name it, using these various brushes. Now, what we're going to do though, is we're going to convert this into a brush. I'm going to go to my brushes panel, which you can also find under Window and Brushes. I'm going to select this and drag it into the panel. I have three options for brushes. I have a scatter brush, an art brush, and a pattern brush. We're going to select the art brush. When we do that, it's going to give us a few options. I'm going to keep everything default, but I'm going to say at the top, custom brush, just to make sure I know what it is, and hit OK. At that point, you now have a stroke within your scene. I can go ahead and hit delete on this. I don't need that shape anymore. I can get my brush tool and check this out. I can actually draw with this specific stroke, which is a kind of really cool technique considering you could make tons of different crosshatching brushes, you name it. All I would really need to do is kind of set my stroke size to where I want it, and I can get some really nice custom line work as I go. This is how you create a brush. If you're wondering, okay, well, what if I want to change that shape? You can just drag that shape back into your artboard, and it's a fully editable vector. You can continue to make brushes on the fly. As you can see here, hit delete. I have a second brush that's a little skinnier, and we'll lower the opacity of that brush just to get some nice line weight. That's a really great option to create brushes, as I mentioned, on the fly. If you want to delete the brush, you just drag them to the delete can at the bottom of the brush panel, and you're good to go. If you're curious about the different brushes that Adobe offers, you can go to the library of brushes, and you'll find tons of different brushes, such as arrows. I can go into the arrow brush, open that up, and now anytime I use my brush, it will be an arrow, which is really nice and very useful actually for doing all sorts of projects. You could continue to append those brushes as you see fit. Now, moving on, another very fun type of brush, and let me hide all our other layers here, is a pattern brush. A pattern brush is a really fun way to create fancy patterns rather than repeating images over and over. This is the same method. You're going to take it, you're going to drag and drop it, and in this time, you're going to select pattern brush. When you hit OK, you're going to get this screen. For the most part, this screen is going to be pretty good. I do like to lower my scale just a little bit on these. I'll show you how to edit that in a second. I can either hit approximate to path or stretch to fit. It's really up to you. Let's start with stretch to fit, and we can change that later. And I'm going to hit OK. I get this brush. What does this do? Well, if I have a stroke and I click on that brush, it's going to apply it to that stroke. How cool is that? If I want to edit that, I go to my little three lines here, this at the top of the brush menu. I'm going to do options for selected object. That's going to bring that back up and allow me to kind of change the different order paths, play with a little bit of the spacing as I see fit, and really customize that brush experience. But this becomes a really powerful tool now because no matter what you draw, as you can see here, no matter the shape, hit escape, there we go. When we hit that brush, we now have that. So you could do all sorts of different ancient type patterns, you name it. This is a great tool for that. And it works with really any shape Once again, I'm going to go to pattern brush. I'm going to just keep it on default here. And if I want to replace that, I can replace that. Go to my options and really shrink that down to get some really fun kind of squiggly options in this case. So pattern brushes are really slept on, but really, really useful tool in any designer's arsenal. Moving on to the next brush, sometimes we have things like illustrations. So in this case, I have this hand. Just like you saw me draw the arrow, what if I wanted to draw this hand like a brush? So I'm going to select this illustration. I'm going to drag and drop it into my art brush category. But I'm going to make one big change. Here, I'm going to stretch between guidelines. And what this will do is this will allow me, if I lower the guideline here, only really to distort what's in between these two dotted lines. I'm going to go down here to the black area, just above it. That looks great, and hit OK. And now, when I hit B for brush, and I grab my line tool, and I draw. Oops, let's draw it out. There we go. You'll notice it stretches, but it keeps the hand uniform. So I can do all sorts of fun little cartoon things. If you're actually animating, this could be a really useful tool to draw out different hand gestures. But check that out. In a matter of seconds, we have some really fun brushes, and it maintains the integrity of this hand as we go. We can also do this on different patterns. All right, in this very last brush, all I need to do is a very similar thing. I'm going to drag and drop, create art brush. In this case, I like to draw my strokes up, so I'm going to do the up arrow. Now, if I want to draw a tree trunk, I could do that. Check that out. It really works in any method. Now, if I want to add leaves to those tree trunks, I can grab my brush tool here, and I can drag a leaf in, and you probably guessed it. But now whenever I want to draw a leaf, I can just come in and draw leaves to my heart's desire. How cool is this? So if you really want to duplicate things and draw things up this way, and I can move those on top so you can see them a little better, it's going to streamline this process ever so nicely. And that is the power of brushes in Adobe Illustrator. I hope you enjoyed this short lesson, and I can't wait to see what creative brushes you create.